What do Valentino Rossi, Casey Stoner, Jorge Lorenzo, Marc Marquez and Pecco Bagnaia all have in common? If you're thinking they've all been world champions in MotoGP, you'd be right. But what we're thinking of is a more particular feat and one that only these five riders hold. Each one of these five riders have at some point won 8 MotoGP races in a single season. With Pecco Bagnaia's victory at the Japanese GP just last weekend, it took him into a very rarefied space where only the very best of our sport occupy. Back in the very first MotoGP season at the dawn of the new era in 2002, Valentino Rossi opened the history books in this area as he went on not just to take 8 victories in that season, but 11. The Doctor's dominance of that time in MotoGP needs little explanation, but that title in 2002 was just the second in a run of 5 straight Premier Class crowns for Rossi from 2001 to 2005, in each of which the Doctor tallied up 8 or more wins. And what's more impressive is that he did so on 2 different brands of machinery. That run of championship dominance would come to an end in 2006 thanks to the efforts of Nicky Hayden and then Casey Stoner in 2007, with the latter being the second rider to add his name into the category of riders with 8 or more wins in a MotoGP season. Stoner's first year with Ducati was famed not just for his incredible speed on the straight, but for the way Casey tamed a bike that didn't want to be tamed. And somehow, the Australian wrangled the Desmos Adici GP7 to an astonishing 10 victories that year. While the Aussie continued to be a prolific winner with Ducati in his remaining years with the Italian squad, it wasn't until his switch to Honda in 2011 before Stoner would win more than 8 races in a single season again. And not to be outdone by his once great rival Rossi, that 2011 season also saw him match him with the feat of winning 8 races in a year for 2 different brands.
6 successive wins here at Phillip Island.
But before Stoner showed his magic on a Honda, Jorge Lorenzo ruled the roost for the first time on a Yamaha. In 2010, Lorenzo won 9 races on his way to his first MotoGP crown, and in particularly impressive fashion, finishing the year on 383 points. His closest championship rival at the end of that year was Dani Pedrosa, some 138 points behind on 245. Interestingly, the second time that Lorenzo won 8 or more races in a year was not, in fact, in his second championship year in 2012, and nor was it his third in 2015. In fact, in 2012, when he went head-to-head with Pedrosa, eventually beating the Spaniard by 28 points, Lorenzo racked up 6 victories compared to Pedrosa's 7. And that 2012 season is the year that Pedrosa came the closest to joining this elite club. Lorenzo's second year of 8 or more wins was in fact 2013, the season that then young rookie Marc Marquez arrived on the scene. Winning the final 3 races of the year to clinch his 8th win at the final round in Valencia, Lorenzo lost out on the title by just 4 points that year, which gives him the rather unfortunate honour of being the only rider in the MotoGP era to have won 8 races in a season and ultimately lose out on the championship. And that brings us neatly on to Marc Marquez. After his rookie crown in 2013, you could say Marc enjoyed having the pressure as MotoGP world champion for the first time at the start of 2014. Not only did Marc win a staggering 10 races in a row to kickstart the year, but he went on to win 13 races in total. And 2014 still stands as the record for the most wins in a single season, beating the 11 wins Rossi achieved in 2002 and 2005. Marc would go on to add to this category of high win percentage seasons by winning 9 races in 2018 before coming close to matching his record in 2019 when he picked up 12 wins on his way to his 6th Premier Class crown. And with Marquez moving to factory Ducati next year, he too has the chance to take his place next to Rossi and Stoner as the only riders to win 8 or more races in a season with 2 different manufacturers. But before 2025, 2024 and Pecco Bagnaia. Bagnaia's 8th win of the season just last weekend in Japan puts his name alongside 4 of motorcycle racing's greatest ever. Pecco has of course come close to winning 8 in a single season before. In the past 2 seasons, his championship years, he's won 7 races in each of those, before now finally managing to better his own personal record and clinch an 8th this year. But with 8 wins under his belt and trailing Jorge Martin by 10 points in the championship, Pecco is under pressure that he could become just the 2nd rider behind Jorge Lorenzo to win 8 and lose the title. With 4 rounds to go, there is the possibility that Bagnaia could get to 12 wins for the season and match what Marc Marquez did in 2019. But motorcycle racing is not that predictable, and this championship battle definitely isn't that predictable either. With mistakes from both of the top 2 contenders, you just never know which way the title pendulum is going to swing from week to week or even day to day. Between the sprint and the GPs on Sunday, we have 2 title contenders that have their clear forte. Jorge Martin this year has taken 131 points from sprint, compared to Bagnaia's 103. With Pecco then reversing the trend on Sundays with 279 points from the GPs compared to Martin's 261. 4 rounds to go, 8 lights out coming your way, and just 10 points splits them. 2024 is bubbling up for its epic grandstand finish.
If you can't get enough MotoGP, click here to subscribe.